very hard to find the limit. Even L'Hôpital's wouldn't help us. Okay. Like we said, the limit of sine of n of cosine of n at infinity doesn't exist. So how could I find then the limit of cosine square of n over 2 here? So what we do, we try to figure out if our sequence is bounded by two sequences. Remember the squeeze theorem in Calc 1? You know, if I can squeeze this function between two functions, then wherever those two functions are going, the middle one is going the same way. So that's what we call the squeeze theorem.
It sounds like the comparison test.
A little bit, yeah. A little bit. So this is what we call the squeeze. Look at the right function. It's the limit is going to zero. Okay? The blue one, that's the cosine square of n of the to the power n. You see, it's always smaller than that one. So it doesn't go beyond. Okay, it's always smaller than that one. So if this one is going towards zero, and this one is smaller, then it has to go towards zero too. Okay? But it, you know, it could have gone towards minus infinity, for example, but it is bounded by zero also. It's never negative. Okay? So this function is bounded by zero and 1/2 cosine squared is always less than one anyway. Okay? So this is my a sub n less than b sub n less than c sub n. And the squeeze theorem says if I know the limit of these two and they go to the same way, then of course this one has to go the same way. Okay. So that's what we call the squeeze theorem. Back home in French they call it, if I translate as that's a theorem of the policeman. So if you know they take you to jail, well, one is here, one is there. Wherever they go, that's where they go. They call it the theorem. So if, what is the limit of when n goes to infinity of zero? When n goes to infinity of 1/2 n, what is going to go to zero? Because this gets bigger and bigger. Okay? Mm-hmm. Then by squeeze theorem, since this one is between those two, well, it cannot go anywhere else but zero. Cosine square of n over 2 n is equal to zero. So that's great for this type of function where there is no way I can find the limit of this top function, for example. If I find limit of cosine square of n by itself, the limit doesn't exist. But if I divide by 2 n, I'm changing this function. I'm changing the limit of this function. And it goes this way. Instead of going this way, it goes... Oh, no, it's positive. It goes this way, and then finally it dies. So the vibrations are not that long anymore, the amplitude. Every time I cut it down until it dies away. And this is the tutorial end of that step. So the squeeze, usually the bottom is something that, you know, is one term, you know. At the top, I can compare with something. Like if I have sine or cosine, I know they're always less than one, for example, between minus one and one. If I have, like, tangent inverse of 2n, well, it's always less than pi over 2, for example. Okay. So functions that you can compare with. And finally, the last theorem here, there was another one. Remember the sequence that was going minus 1/3, 1/9. Okay? So how do I find the limit of those? Because I have, here I have negative 1 to the n over, let's say, 3 to the n. Okay? I can find the limit of 3 to the n, you know, as n increases, 3 to the n gets bigger and bigger. But minus 1 to the n doesn't have a limit. It's minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 1. So the limit doesn't exist. So we have a problem here again. Okay? But for this type of problem, I mean, you know, function or sequences, what do? We find the absolute value of the sequence first. So we make the sequence positive. That's what we do. So negative 1 to the n, if I take absolute value of minus 1 is 1, absolute value of 1 is 1. So it becomes just 1 to the n over 3 to the n. But 1 to any power is just 1. So it becomes 1 over 3 to the n. So what we do, we try to eliminate that problem right here by taking the absolute value. And then what is the limit of this? If the limit of this exists and is a number, equal to 0, sorry. This is the limit as n goes to infinity, 1 over 3 to the n. Of course, this goes to 0. Then I can say, the limit of the absolute value is 0, then limit of the sequence itself is at the absolute value of those. And this is how it works visually. I have a sequence doing this. So one is here, one is here, one is here, positive, negative, positive, negative. The behavior, they're all going towards zero. Okay? But if I can make it positive, it means I flip this one right here. I flip this one right here. I make everything positive. So as you can see, this is going towards zero. So if the absolute value is going towards zero, the sequence itself is going towards zero. If the absolute value is not going towards zero, I would have something like this, for example. But if I flip the positive, the negative, I make them all positive, what happens? The limit is going towards infinity. So I cannot say that the limit exists and is equal to zero anymore. Okay? So absolute value has to have a limit of zero for the sequence to have a limit of zero. So that's another theorem, just to figure out the limit of those type of functions.